Even if you're not the biggest fan of camping, some of the food that you associate with campfires is absolutely stunning. I'm going to be cooking one of those campfire favourites. It's a sausage and bean stew.
Made with thick butcher's sausages, chorizo, bacon and white beans. I'll be cooking this rustic stew on my version of the campfire, the charcoal barbecue.
The first thing I'm going to do is put an oven-proof and solid pan into the coals, directly into it. Let it get nice and hot.
First ingredient is onion, chopped, and with a good glug of veg oil, that goes into my heated pot. Next in are slices of the chorizo sausage.
Campfire food wouldn't be great campfire food without some bacon. Now, this is a whole piece of smoked streaky bacon, and I'm just going to cut it into lardons. You want it quite chunky, OK? So just drop that in as well.
Next to go in are 3 cloves of garlic, some rich red smoked paprika, and for a bit of sweet and sour, some caster sugar and red wine vinegar.
Now look at those colours, they're bright, they're vibrant. That smoked paprika has made everything go this wonderful rich red. It looks incredible.
Now I've got a rich tasty base for the stew. I'm adding a tablespoon of tomato puree, 100 ml of red wine, 2 bay leaves, a good sprig of thyme still on the stalk, and 2 tins of chopped tomatoes.
Lid goes on. I'm just going to change the way that these coals are for a minute. I'm going to take the tomato sauce off, move the coals all down to one end, and then giving myself a little space to the side.
Now, with a gentler heat, my sauce can simmer away, but will still need turning to cook through. My sausages are going in a great bit of campfire kit, a grill cage, which means they can go directly onto the hot coals to get charred skins.
Want to get those skins, the outer sides of the sausages, cooked, flavoursome, smoky, before they go into that stew. OK, the sausages are colouring up lovely one side. I'm just going to turn them over. I'm going to turn my stew around as well.
At this point, add 2 tins of drained white beans. I'm using cannellini, but any cooked pulse would work fine. Stir, season with a good pinch of salt, and then check on those sausages.
Yes, sausages done in a frying pan for a full English breakfast at home are lovely, but there's something so special about the smell of a campfire sausage. Smoky, slightly charred, burnt bits. It's absolutely beautiful.
These guys go whole into the pot where they'll cook through.
So they're going to stew and cook for about another 20 minutes, half an hour. Give you enough time to put your tent up. Not me, obviously, I'd need about 4 hours. However, you know, as I'm here, I'm just going to make a cup of tea.
And the great thing about a stew like this is the longer you leave it, the better it gets. Rich, hearty and delicious. Serve it with a bit of crusty bread, and this is a campfire classic taken to a new level.
Delicious, full-flavoured, smoky from that paprika. The chorizo is incredible. The tomato sauce has got a lovely layer of acidity to it, but you know what? That bit of sugar, the sweetness that comes with it. Oh, smoky, rich, tomatoey, campfire goodness. What more do you want? delicious. Cooking on campfires is such a great thing to do. I mean, it means you're outdoors, but it normally involves the kids and lots of people having fun. So I'm going to create a dish that is really simple and is one of the nation's favourite. In fact, it's the nation's favourite sandwich.
And that is a BLT. Except my BLT has a few differences. It's got chicken in it and avocado, and it's dressed with a mouth-wateringly herby mayonnaise and is cooked on the barbecue.
So there's a couple of things that you can do beforehand to get it all packed up and ready to go. So you can take it with you so that when you get to the campsite, it's just an assembly job. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is bash out the chicken breasts so that they're relatively thin and all the same size. Now, there's a reason for doing that, and it's because sometimes when you get to campsites, what you have to cook on isn't always the best. So I want to make sure that this chicken can be cooked properly and evenly all the way through. So, between two layers of cling film, bash out the chicken breast to about a centimetre thick.
I'm going to knock together a marinade for the chicken of rosemary, garlic and some olive oil. A good rub and the chicken is ready for later. The other part that you can prep before you go is the sauce, and I'm making a spicy herby mayonnaise.
The purpose of making like a lovely mayonnaise or dressing like this, I mean, you can stick a bottle of ketchup in the car and take it with you, that's no problem. But actually making that bit of effort makes everything feel a bit more special.
This starts with 4 tablespoons of mayonnaise, 2 of sour cream, and 2 great big squirts of American-style mustard. For some extra spice, add hot sauce. A few drops of Worcester sauce, a pinch of cayenne pepper, and to freshen it all up, some dill. With that done, you're ready to go off on your idyllic camping adventure. And the BLT starts with the B.
So I've got here my bacon. I'm using streaky bacon, I love it. I mean, basically it's cured pork belly. I mean, how lush is that? So that is gonna go straight onto the barbecue. And then my chicken breasts, they go on as well.
The chicken should sear on the outside first, then cook through to the middle. And the fat dripping on the coals below gives it all a flame-grilled flavour.
It's all well and good going camping. Some of us absolutely love it. Some of us aren't the biggest fans, but I do like the cooking. And the other bonus, if you end up being the cook, means it's somebody else putting the tent up. Bacon is cooked beautifully, and my chicken, I'm just going to give it a little sprinkle of salt, and then off it comes. Then I'm just going to toast a couple of chia butter buns. Now, I like chia butter buns because they're kind of that beautiful mixture of crispy but chewy dough. Those are the bottoms, OK? I'm going to put some of this lovely but quite loose full-flavoured herby mayonnaise.
On top of that goes the tea of tomato and a pinch of salt. Then the char-grilled chicken, the bee of the crispy bacon, some sliced avocado, the L of the lettuce, and a last splash of mayo. Lid on.
And then that's it. I mean, it couldn't be much simpler, could it? You've done most of the work at home. You brought it with you, you've whacked it on a barbecue, you haven't had to put the tent up, and now you've created Britain's favourite sandwich just a little bit better.